Welcome to Moo Math and Science. In this video, I'd like to talk about energy flow in an ecosystem. All living things, which are biotic factors, require energy. Some of these biotic factors get their energy from the sun. Others eat other biotic factors. As a result, energy flows in ecosystems. This flow of energy can be represented with food chains and food webs. For most ecosystems, the ultimate source of energy is the sun. And as you move from one organism to another, you move up a trophic level. For example, moving from the mollusk to the white perch would be a trophic level. Producers use photosynthesis to create their energy, and they are a very large source of energy in most ecosystems. Plants and algae are examples. As consumers eat these producers, carbon bonds are broken and energy is released, and this energy is transferred from one level to another. However, as you move from one trophic level to another, you lose 90% of this energy. This is known as the 10% rule. For example, if you start with 1,000 joules of grass and a grasshopper eats the plant, only 10 joules will be transferred. And a bird eats the insect, only 1 joule will be transferred. Where does this energy go? Most of the energy is lost as heat. The energy flow in an ecosystem follows the laws of thermodynamics. The first law states that energy cannot be created nor destroyed in a system. However, it can be converted from one form to another. The second law states that this energy conversion is never completely efficient, and as a result, most of your energy is lost as heat. So there we go, the energy flow in an ecosystem. Thanks for watching, and Moo Moo Math uploads a new math and science video every day. Please subscribe and share.